Hey guys, it's Danny. Okay, let's make a little update on my gifted orchids and the orchids that came from the swap with Ana Maria. And today is really gloomy. These days are awful and I don't have too much light, so excuse the exposure. Pretty much that's the reason why I placed so many lights in my greenhouse so I can film whenever. But anyway, let's get to the update. So actually last time I got from her some surprise orchids. And these are it. I actually opted to keep them in a little bit of sphagnum moss. They're not actually potted. Everything is very loose here. So you see, they're not stable. But I did want to give them more humidity. I didn't want to place them in water because, you know, I was scared. So I just placed them in some damp sphagnum moss. And this is the Paphiopetalum henrianum. As you can see, he is okay, but I did notice that he could use a few more roots. Now, Paphiopetalums are actually pretty hardy orchids, so I hope that when I pot him up, he'll start to produce a nice root system. This is the Calea for Bessie. You might call her for Bessiae, but being that I am kind of Latin, I kind of pronounce stuff in Latin. So however you want to pronounce it, for Bessiae, whatever. So you can see she has quite a nice root system, and I do want to keep them a little bit more moist. Because if I just spray them every day, they kind of dry up very, very fast, and it's a bit of a lost time that I don't have right now. But she is very, very loose in her pot. I'll make her stable when I pot her up, but she's doing okay. And this is the Dendrobium rhodostictum. Now this guy doesn't really have too many good roots, actually. So for this reason, he's kind of shriveled. This little bulb on transport got broken, but it's okay. I really just hope he has some more available eyes. Also, these plants had snails, and Ana Maria warned me about it. And I see quite a lot of snail bites. I'll show you on a different orchid. And there was a new eye developing here. Oh, this damn light. I cannot really show you, but the tip of the new growth was munched off by snails, so I'm not sure if that eye is still available. But hopefully we have some more eyes. But yeah, I'm a bit sad about this guy. I really hope he's gonna make a recovery. I don't know how hardy this plant is. I really hope it's hardy. Here's the Lelia Diana. This is a mini Cattleya. And as you can see, she got a little bit dehydrated. That's why I placed her in moss. She's actually looking a little bit better now. These roots are viable, but I just need to keep her hydrated. However, the good news is she's producing a new root right here. Oh, this is a good light. So you can see she's actually, oh, don't fall. She's growing. I cannot wait to pot her up, really. Also, the snail damage on this one is very visible. Let me show you one of the leaves. Do you see here? This got munched off and some of the roots got munched away as well. So yeah, these orchids had snails. They were sprayed with hydrogen peroxide and they're clean now. But yeah, it's something to look out for. If you see this on an orchid, this is snails or slug damage. So be careful with that, because snails and slugs do eat new growth, new root tips and so on. I really hope I get to show you some blooms sooner rather than later. I know she's tiny, but she is a mini Cattleya, because the blooms on this one, they're amazing. Okay, this is the Brassia hybrid. Gilded Tower Mystic Maze. Okay, so this one, as you can see, she doesn't have too many leaves, but these pseudobulbs remained plump. She has quite a nice root system, and this growth right here is actually starting to grow. She's plumping up. She's doing quite well. I didn't cut anything just yet. She does have a few dead roots, but I'll just clean it up afterwards. She just has so many roots right now, I just wanted her to be hydrated, but I'll take care of it before I actually pot it up. I'll just check each individual root and see if it's alive. Here are two more orchids. They came from the swap along with the Brassia hybrid. This is the Reichera Francis Fox, and she's doing quite fine. The display on this one, I didn't want to put her in sphagnum moss. She's a big girl. It would have been a bit hard for me to stabilize it, but I just tied her to the stake and she's kind of hanging at the moment. So I spray her a few times a day, actually. Yeah, I give her that time because she's beautiful. So the roots are actually growing on this one. I have another one in the back here. And also the available eye is growing, as you can see. Again, cannot wait to put her up because she is ready to grow. And here we have the LC Tropical Pointer. And this root is viable. Although the tip is not good anymore, the root is viable. I do, however, have a growing root tip here. He's trying to attach to stuff. Please focus, camera. So yeah, again, cannot wait to pop them up. These new growths fare well. This has opened a little bit more. This one, however, not that much as far as I can see, But I think he's okay. He doesn't look rotten in any way. The little root is growing. She's fine, but yeah, she could use some potting up. And here's the ICU. It's in the balcony right now. I needed my desk cleared, so I just moved this guy here. I know spider mites and all of that, but I decided, well, kind of my boyfriend made me decide that, you know what, let's just put some pesticides on everyone so we don't have any more trouble in the future. And yeah, since everybody will be sprayed with miticide, even if they get a few spider mites right now, they're not gonna do too much damage. The crucial part was over with these guys, so that's that. I give up the fight, you guys. I can't take it anymore. Spider mites actually killed some of my orchids. I don't want to go through that again. I'll just focus on prevention. But right now, I really do need to use that pesticide. I don't want to introduce spider mites in the greenhouse. However, the ICU is doing quite nice. Some of them are growing quite well. No more deaths, which is nice. You know, the orchids, this is still struggling a little bit, but she's not depleting herself, which is good. It's nice. The new growth is growing, but please make some roots fast, please. This guy, oh, look at him. He's growing quite nice. Everybody's going quite okay. I also did something with my, what's your name? Selaginii pungerata. There you go. So her roots were not growing too well because of the lack of moisture. I was keeping her on that stake. So I actually made a little sort of a bowl for her because she's just too tiny to be placed in a pot. I don't want to place her in a pot because I just want to pick her up and pack her and that's that. But I did place her in this sort of a pot cutaway, this portion here because of the growth. And I keep the sphagnum moss moist because she does have growing roots, but they grow slow if they don't have moisture. So that's what I'm doing with this one. And a few others. This came from the ICU as well. There's not much happening, so I don't know. I don't know about this one, but she's not dying. And I think that was pretty much it from the orchids that I received from Ana Maria. So yeah, overall, even if some were sick, some really bounced back fast. Some took a while, some are still, I don't know. But I think it's a good ratio. I'm very thankful for them, really. There's a whole bunch of orchids here, and they're gonna fill up my greenhouse nicely. So thank you, Ana Maria. And as you can see, they're not doing all that bad. They just require time to plump back up and to go into their normal rhythm, but they're doing okay. They're on the right track, I would say. Obviously, they will do much better when I can pot them up, offer humidity, fertilizer in some cases. Oh, they should really pick up growth with fertilizer. So, yeah. Okay, guys, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. If you want to stay up to date with my orchids, move, and everything, just subscribe to my channel. I post on a daily basis. Also, feel free to leave me questions, suggestions you might have for videos in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you. If you click on the left side of your screen, you'll be directed to orchidnature.com, where you'll find care sheets, identification sheets, and also you can talk to us in the forum section. And on the right side of your screen, you can click to watch another orchid video. Thank you for joining. I'll see you next time. Bye!